New leaked recordings of former Trump lawyer Kenneth Chesebro show him basically describing a 2020 Oval Office photo op where he and other lawyers were instructed to not egg on Donald Trump in this whole election interference nonsense and basically let him know, listen, honey, you've lost the election. It's time to move on. That was the point of Trump's meeting with these lawyers. Now, the recordings are from Michigan State prosecutor's recent interview with Chesebro, an unindicted co-conspirator who is cooperating with state investigators working on the whole fake electors case. Now, what's interesting is that Kenneth Chesebro admits that even though the lawyers present at that Oval Office photo op were supposed to discourage Trump from moving forward with all this election interference nonsense, he confesses that, yeah, I actually did kind of egg him on. So Chesebro's the guy who was responsible for writing a legal memo that transformed into a nationwide operation to overturn the results of the presidential election, right? The fake electors plot. And so here's what we learned from the tapes that have been leaked. On December 14th of 2020, the Wisconsin Supreme Court rejected Trump's lawsuit to nullify the state's election results. Days later, a guy named Jim Troupis, and other GOP lawyers involved in the case flew to Washington, D.C., and they participated in this Senate hearing about election issues and also secured an Oval Office photo op with Donald Trump. Now, Chesebro revealed that before the group of lawyers entered the Oval Office, they were given clear instructions to not get Trump's hopes up about overturning the election. And look, it's not clear who gave that directive. We don't know who it is, but Chesebro says that's what they were supposed to do. Now, Troupis towed the line. He listened to the orders. He just finished leading Trump's failed election challenge in Wisconsin and bluntly told the president that it was just over in that state, time to move on. Now, Chesebro details that situation in the leaked audio that you're about to hear.
Clear that Troupis personally told the president there was zero hope for Wisconsin. As part of this message, I think crafted to try to get him to concede, to just give up this long shot challenge. So there was a conscious effort to deflect him from a sense of any possibility that he could pull out the election.
Okay, so now he continues to say, Chesebro continues to say, our marching orders were, don't say anything that makes him feel more positive than the beginning of the meeting. So let's just rehash what I just covered, okay? So you have the majority of the Republican lawyers in the Oval Office telling Trump, it's over, don't get your hopes up, you're not gonna overturn the results of this election. But you have Chesebro egging him on with the fake elector scheme. And by the way, I should note, the reason why Chesebro is willing to cooperate with these investigations is because he took a plea deal and he has immunity. So this essentially protects him while opening up potentially a whole host of issues for Donald Trump. But I do think there's a catch, and I'll tell you what that catch is in just a moment. But first, we need to hear more audio. So then the conversation shifted to Arizona, okay? Attorney Kenneth Chesebro at that point deviated from the plan, implying to Trump that, hey, you could still win this. Let's watch.
So I ended up explaining that Arizona was still hypothetically possible because the alternate electors had voted. And I explained the whole logic that because the alternate electors had voted, we had more time to win the litigation. So it was, I think, clear in a way that maybe it hadn't been before that we had till January 6th to win.
So he's giving Trump, honestly, false hope, clearly false hope. And I think that's what's gonna complicate this case. Now, in this situation, obviously, we're talking about a state that's investigating the fake elector scheme. But remember, you have legal experts, you have lawyers talking to Trump, some of which, like Kenneth Chesebro, are telling him exactly what he wants to hear and telling him that what they're about to do, based on what we know so far, is totally above board. I don't know if that's gonna work in Trump's favor. I don't know if he's going to effectively use that as part of his defense. Now, Chesebro spelled out the basics of the fake elector scheme, where Trump supporters in 7 states would cast fake ballots and they would sign phony certificates claiming that they were the rightful electors. Obviously, they were not. In fact, some of these fake electors are now facing criminal charges for what they did. Now, that angered other officials who knew it would give Trump renewed hope that he could still somehow stay in office.
Right after the meeting, Troupis said that Ryan Troupis was extremely concerned with what I told the president about Arizona and about the real deadline being January 6th, and that he was going to do damage control. Ryan was going to follow up, and I was trying to mitigate whatever optimism I guess I created.
It's really sad when we're now living in a world where Reince Priebus, if you can remember that guy, is the voice of reason. So incredibly depressing. So another source said that a visibly ticked off Reince Priebus intervened to shut down the conversation after he saw Chesebro whispering to Trump about election procedures. He's like, get out of here. Of course, Priebus and others ended up being right. Trump heard what he wanted to hear in that meeting. So he effectively ignored the legal experts, the lawyers who were telling him, you're not going to win this, this isn't going to work. And instead chose to listen to Kenneth Chesebro instead, the very man who's now spilling the beans and basically offering testimony against Donald Trump and the other co-conspirators in these investigations. Now, afterward, Chesebro says that Priebus wanted to keep the meeting on the down low. Sorry, Priebus, obviously that didn't happen. And 2 days later, Chesebro got a stern email from Troupis. The message said the following, quote, Reince was very explicit in his admonition that nothing about our meeting with the president can be shared with anyone. The political cross currents are deep and fast, and neither you or I have any ability to swim through them. Also during this interview, Michigan investigators asked Chesebro detailed questions, including who designed the fake certificates that the GOP elector signed, and who was responsible for recruiting the Michigan participants? How did the signed certificates get from Lansing to Washington, D.C.? And also, he pointed investigators to Rudy Giuliani, who was pushing the idea of alternate electors very strongly, and said former NYPD commissioner Bernie Carrick handled a lot of the organizational activity in Michigan. Trump campaign official Mike Roman was really effective at carrying out operational matters, Chesebro said. He's throwing everyone under the bus. Everyone's under the bus. So he was picked to be the point person to help with the whipping operation on a state by state basis. So I do think that Chesebro's testimony is incredibly valuable here. Now, why does this all matter? What does this all mean? Well, Chesebro's testimony could be useful for the federal indictment that Donald Trump is facing for election interference. In Trump's federal case, prosecutors highlighted the pattern of Trump allies repeatedly telling him that he lost the election. See, this is why I'm worried, because yes, there were people telling him repeatedly that he lost the election, but there were also others, including literal lawyers like Kenneth Chesebro, telling him, no, you could still win this. You get what I'm saying? So if Jack Smith is really leaning into this notion that, oh, everyone's telling Trump that you've lost, you've got no chance, you need to move on, and Trump decided to move forward with the fake elector plot anyway, well, Trump's legal team can argue, well, there were also legal experts and lawyers telling him otherwise. And so can that be an effective defense? I don't know, and I'm not a legal expert, so I guess we're gonna have to wait and see. But let me read the rest of that graphic for you. In Trump's federal case, prosecutors highlighted the pattern of Trump allies repeatedly telling him that he lost the election. This forms the basis of Smith's allegation that Trump widely disseminated his false claims of election fraud for months, despite the fact that he knew, and in many cases had been informed directly, that they were not true. So Jack Smith would have to prove that Trump knew. And with Chesebro's testimony here, with the cooperation that he's providing in, you know, various situations, in this case, the Michigan investigation, I think that that testimony can actually muddy the waters a little bit for Jack Smith's prosecutorial procedure here, what his plans are, what his strategy is. Now Smith has more examples of Trump being explicitly told by his lawyers that he would not be able to overturn the results of the election. That is true. As for Chesebro, he apparently isn't the only one cooperating with Michigan. Chesebro is cooperating with state investigators in Michigan, Nevada, Wisconsin, and Georgia, where he was indicted alongside Trump and 17 others and pleaded guilty in October to participating in the electors' conspiracy. In fact, he's listed as co-conspirator 5 in that Georgia election interference trial. And what I love is that he was the idiot. Like, this guy passed the bar. He's a literal lawyer, okay? This is the guy who in the memos used phrasing like fake electors, fraudulent electors. I mean, leaving a paper trail where you're acknowledging that what you're engaging in is fraudulent. It's unbelievable stuff.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.